Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of What Is, the video series where I give spoiler-free first looks and reviews on video games. This episode, we have a very, very early look at a game that is currently having its pre-alpha playtest. Let us discuss What Is Vindictus, Defying Fate. Vindictus Defying Fate is an action RPG based on the 2010 MMORPG Vindictus, a Korean free-to-play MMO that, from my research, is still kicking. Defying Fate is currently being developed on the Unreal Engine 5, and as stated before, this playtest is a pre-alpha build for the game. The demo is very obviously missing a lot of features that will be missing from the final product, but we get a solid look at what the developers are aiming for with Defying Fate. As far as the story goes, there's no dialogue at all in the demo whatsoever. We get a few cutscenes of gnolls walking and soldiers getting absolutely wrecked, but that's pretty much it. So in terms of narrative and storytelling, we're gonna have to just wait and see. During this demo, we were able to play as two different characters. Fiona, who uses a sword and shield, and Lan, who dual wields swords. Each character has four different combos they can execute, four different active abilities, and a unique skill that is catered to each character's playstyle. Both characters played vastly different from each other. While neither one is the type of character I would like to play in these action RPG, Souls-like type games, they were pretty fun once I did get the hang of them. Fiona's playstyle revolved around her shield, whether using it defensively to block or offensively to knock enemies back and get a brief stagger on them. Her unique ability puts her in a defensive stance that is used to reduce incoming damage. However, the longer you hold that button down, the less damage reduction players get. Timing the enemy attacks with her defensive stance started to become key in my success with her. Lan's playstyle revolves around his quick hitting attacks and dipping in and out of the enemy's range to be effective. His unique ability is a dash that slashes through enemies. The screen where combos and abilities are shown says that it has two charges max, but I saw no feedback showing these charges on the screen or my HUD whatsoever, and I was never able to chain two of them together whenever I was playing as him. However, weaving this in at the end of combos and after active abilities felt really, really good. Visually, the game looks great so far. Being on Unreal Engine 5, I'm not that surprised. From the models of the characters and enemies to the overall environment, I found myself using the bare bones photo mode just to take everything in for a moment. The demo's performance did vary, but I didn't find myself dipping down to unplayable territory at any moment. Unfortunately, there weren't many options at all to ensure higher performance. There's a general quality preset, a VSync option, and just three different options for upscaling methods with their presets underneath those as well. What's most important though is Nexon made sure we had different outfits for the characters and a plethora of emotes to choose from. From the brief bit of research I've done on the original Vindictus, it is basically a waifu dress-up simulator nowadays. And well, they seem to be carrying over that same mindset a bit into Defying Fate. Animations in the demo felt and looked great. From the playable characters to the enemies, everything flowed nicely. Enemy attacks are easy to read and dodge as long as you're paying attention. And character attacks and combos flowed together and nothing felt janky or out of place when in combat. And well, these character emotes, they're... yeah. I'm really happy Nexon made sure that this and the outfits were in their playtest for the pre-alpha of the game and really focused time and energy and resources on this stuff for pre-alpha. Yeah. This pre-alpha test for Vindictus Defying Fate is not something we see devs do often, but it's nice to see. Usually it's a beta test a week out from a game's release, which is usually just meant to generate hype rather than gathering valuable information to help develop a game. One thing I ask is that they open up the graphics options. None of this three-option bullshit. We aren't playing this game on consoles where the hardware is standard for everyone. PC hardware varies widely, and giving players options to cater to their systems is a must. And honestly, there's no excuse to omit these options from PC versions of games nowadays. Oh, and focus on the gameplay first. Don't add in these costumes and emotes and stuff like that. I get they're a big moneymaker with the original game. I get people are into that type of stuff. But focus on making a good game first, then add in all the cosmetics and all the other bullshit afterwards. That's my big ask. Thank you all so much for watching the video today. Please subscribe to the channel if you are not already. Hit the like button and let me know what your favorite candy is in the comment section down below. By doing these three simple things that are free to you, it helps the video reach new people an insane amount. I'll see you guys in the next one.